I'm going to ask a question now. Can you tell me now the difference between the very first pylon and the second pylon? Can you tell me the difference?
That one's more decorated pylon.
This is finished.
That's finished.
You see the carving, colored and painted. But that one?
It's plain.
I told you it was never finished because the king didn't have time. He passed away.
Yeah.
You see? Now, that statue for Ramses II, the greatest pharaoh, you remember? And between his legs, all the guides and all the books, they say that is his wife Nefertari. But believe me not.
No?
That is one of his daughters. He married her later on. At the time, in the religion, it was legal to marry your half-sister, your daughter. But to keep the royal blood. It was not like to keep the royal blood. Okay? And Ramses II, we call him the greatest, but he committed three big mistakes. One of them, he married four of his own daughters. Okay? The second mistake, I think he didn't know that his people used to do that. They used to erase other kings' names from their statues and publish his name instead. The third mistake in the Valley of the Kings, he built the tomb of his wife, Nefertari, next door to the tomb of his mother. I think this is the third mistake because he gave them the chance to be nagging in the afterlife like the first life. Mother-in-law and a wife's son never come together even in Egypt now. We don't like each other, we hate each other. And from my point of view, this is the third mistake. So that statue, we call it mummy form. You know mummy? Like a mummy, like this.
Right.
Crossed hands. And means dead. You find statues for kings, left leg forward.
Mm-hmm.
Like that.
Right.
And this is means life, peace, eternity. But you can't find any statue in Egypt right leg forward. No one. Did you find one?
No.
Never
no.
Exists. Because this position means aggression. Fighting. So the Egyptians didn't like to be aggressive, that's why they didn't carve any statues right leg forward. Okay? So the position of the statues, mummy form dead or left forward. Okay?
More this way, a little bit more, a little bit more.
Like this.
We lost our guy.
Very quickly. Look, the king on the right hand side. Make offering to whom? That is Amun-Re. You see Amun-Re, the one in the middle with the two plumes.
Yeah.
And that is Khonsu, the moon god. You remember?
Yeah.
Amun above his head. That is his son. If you go to the top, you are going to see the same scene, Amun-Re and Khonsu. If you go to the third level, you find Amun-Re and Mut, the one in the back, Mut, his wife, the wife of Amun-Re. Okay? So this is Amun-Re as a human. You remember I told you with the two blooms, with the two. Look, this pylon is finished. Look, everything was colored and painted. Look at the colors. We didn't even do some cleaning here yet. If we do some cleaning, it will be very bright colors. And the Egyptians, they make colors from minerals.
Myself,
if I would like to, when I do like, students come from the States.
Uh-huh.
I spent in this temple about minimum 3-4 days with them.
Yeah, I
minimum
can
5 hours a day. Look, this is ancient Egyptian. Still here. This is ancient Egyptian. But this is Greek.
Uh-huh.
How did we know? Look, I show you. Look. If you read hieroglyphic, this cartouche is a Greek cartouche. Look, B, T, L, O, M, the two fetters is Y, it's Ptolemy, Ptolemy.
Ah, Ptolemy.
So how did you know? From the Cartouche. Ptolemy, the Greek,
the last,
the title, Ptolemy. So this is Greek letter. The difference between this one and this one is almost about maybe Ramses about 1,500 years. Between this and this.
They want from Cleopatra?
This is a Greek Cartouche.
Yes, that's the Ptolemy's
Greek.
Cleopatra's
yes.
Bloodline.
Yes, that is her family. Look. Yes, because you know the empire of Alexander Great or had been divided between his generals, and one of the generals he took Egypt.
Yes.
His name is called Ptolemy.
Ptolemy. Yes. Yes.
Okay. So they had 13 Ptolemies ruled over Egypt.
Which Ptolemy was this?
Huh?
Which Ptolemy?
This is Ptolemy number 4.
Number 4.
Without touching.
I'm sorry.
Look. You remember I told you before building the High Dam in 1971, we are going to visit it in Aswan. We used to have a high flood cover the Nile Valley for 4 months. It was called flood season. And even the water during the flood season used to come inside this temple. And look, this graffiti show you the level of the water inside this temple during the flood season. When you read Arabic, we read from right to left, is the letter in Fayadan, means flood, reach it to that level in 1887.
Wow.
In 1887. But do you think the water of the Nile when it used to come here used to be good or bad? Very good. Why? Because it used to wash and clean temples from soil and seepage. You know seepage? When seepage went up, underground water come higher, it looks like oil. Look, this is seepage. You see this color? Seepage. Okay? And this is affects the Egyptian
peasants. Hypostyle Hall.
Okay. This is the Hypostyle Hall. Look, this one. How many columns? 134 columns. It used to, the two rows in the middle are higher, 22 meters, open papyrus. The side columns, 13 meters, closed papyrus. It looks like a royal tent. Every small inch in the columns, the ceiling had been carved, colored, painted. The original floor was from alabaster. This is not the original floor. Okay? It was too dark during the day. That's why they left for us windows to give light. I will show you the windows. How many kings they built this? Three different kings. Amun-Re III, the 18th dynasty, built this. This is Seti I, the father of Ramses II, and this is Ramses II. Ramses II carried the responsibility of carving and coloring the whole colony. That's why if you read any cartouche here, you'll find Ramses II. Ramses II.
I told his name on everything.
Look. That is King Tut. Tutankhamun. That is King Tut. Tutankhamun. But all the guys, all the books, they say Amun-Re. Why? Because of the two floors. The two floors. That's actually round face here. Tutankhamun. And that is his wife. But if you... One of the bad habits from second...
Putting his name everywhere.
Everything and reshaping the statue.
This is Tutankhamun, and yeah. That is his wife. Come, please. Look. This is Ra, M-S-S, Ramses, Miriamun, the name of Ramses II. He erased, look, he defaced the name of Tutankhamun and put his own name.
So
in the top.
Tutankhamun was first?
Earlier, 18th dynasty,
oh, okay.
But Ramses II, 19th dynasty.
And Tutankhamun was too young, right?
when he became a king, he was 9. When he passed away, he was exactly 18 years old. So the statue is Tutankhamun, but the names are Ramses. Do you remember one of the bad habits from Ramses?
Well, he thought it was a good habit.
He had a huge ego.
Yes, he did.
This is Indiana Jones. This is a lion. Mummy Return. Mummy movies. You know, James Bond movies, all of them have been filmed here. All of them. Just like the movie. You see the colors? You see the cartouches? It's the beat. The colors.
Oh,
it looks
right.
Like just finished 5 minutes ago. Do you remember how many columns here? 134 columns. 134. It's completely a stone roof in the top.
Amazing.
The earthquake 27 BC affected this column.
The paint is still there.
Amazing. Look, some people in Jalabiya, long dresses, the guards, they would like you to take you here and there. Don't go with them because they need money.
Okay. We know. We've been in Cairo. We know.
I don't know. Don't sit on a camel.
I am here to take care of you. Okay. So enjoy your time to collect some pictures.
Okay, 10 minutes.
Here,
okay.
And you'll find me here.
1:45. All right.
Okay.
Thanks.
Enjoy.
Okay, Tiffany, put your arms around the column to get an idea how big it is. Oh, hang on. Backing up. Okay.
How much do I owe the visit? Just a mere near.
Oh, yeah, it is a little sore. So Seti built this, Ramses built the other side. I don't. I'm going to the Ramses side. Oh, these have these little stools, like sit on it. Those, I guess they did too. Oh, this one looks interesting. It's like a pyramid with an alien inside. Does it look like an alien? Oh, I like this. This is like a bird, like an eagle.
Смотрите, кто были изображены здесь?
Жрецы.
Молодец. У всех одна форма одежды, и у всех один парикмахер. Видно? Жрецы. А здесь кто он? Главный жрец в шкуре леопарда, и на его голове другие из них видно, голова леопарда. Больше впечатляет 2 метра налево. Вот он. На его голове синий военный царский шлем и на руку проводный защитный сорок он был в шкуре его брата. Вот так. И на шкуре его
get those colors there, yellow. There's yellow.
Sorry, what? Oh, there's colors on the columns, like yellow, blue, green, red.
And on that one, they're all there.
They thought the very top, this part, was the house of the sun god Ra. Ra's home. That's why he left that part plain without any carving. Why? Because it's used to cover that part with 80% gold, 20% silver. What do we call it? We call it electrum. So when the sun rays come over the apex in the early morning, it used to shine. So what did you say? The sun god Ra came to his house. So people used to hurry up from outside, heading to the obelisk to worship the sun. So we can say the obelisk, you know, is one of the images, one of the manifestation of the sun god Ra. Okay? And with that obelisk, we are going to see it now, 174 tons, one piece without the base, 22 meters high. This one out of four. Three of them are outside Egypt, one in Turkey in Istanbul, and two in Italy in Rome. In Italy, they had got till now about 16 ancient Egyptian obelisks. Because most of the Egyptologists, archaeologists, they excavated the temples, they were Italian, like Belzoni, Italian Egyptologists. They looted a lot of, you know, obelisks and removed them.
Yes, in Italy. They're all over. Okay.
So this one, it belongs to the father of Queen Hatshepsut. Did you hear about Hatshepsut?
Yes.
Hatshepsut?
Yeah. We saw her statue.
She was the only queen who ruled over Egypt as a man. She was a woman, and because of the man, she
had one man
because she got only one. As a queen, one cartouche, but when she became a king, she got two cartouches.
She should
because
have.
She ruled over Egypt as a man. She dressed like a man, of course, being limited dress, and she invented the story. To support herself on the throne of Egypt, she said that Amun-Ra, the main god of Egypt, made a very quick visit to the bedroom of her mother after midnight, and he could impregnate her in her nose with Ankh. You know Ankh? The key of life. like a cross. In her notes, she became pregnant with Queen Hatshepsut. Through that divine birth story, she could convince the Egyptian people that she was from a divine birth. She had the right for the throne to rule over Egypt as a man. That's why she dressed like a man, and she ruled over Egypt as a man 20 years. What happened after that? She suddenly disappeared. Her stepson, that the one she sent him to jail, and she took the throne from him. His name is called Thutmose III. He grown up, he came back, he recognized what happened to him. He killed her and got rid of her body, and he became a king of Egypt. And he started to get revenge from her, till he came to her temple and demolished all her statues.
What a guy. You're
going to be king,
you
better not fall. That's true.
Can't be your
boy.
Yes, please, thank you.
Oh, yeah. Initiate. Look, Hatshepsut, I told you this temple for kings to build, not for queens.
Right.
We have one exception. Only Queen Hatshepsut is permitted for her to erect something for Amun-Ra. What she erect? She had erected two obelisks. One of them is still standing, that one. 323 tons. One piece of granite, 29 and a half meters high without the base. Where is the second one? The second one is supposed to be here, behind this wall, but it was damaged because of an earthquake, 27 BC. We are going to see the top of that broken obelisk laid down in a sacred lake after a few minutes. The story of the two obelisks is carved in the base. You see the history? You see the hieroglyph in the base? It tells us it took only 7 months to cut both, polish, carve, move, transport from Aswan to here, and direct them here only 7 months. Both.
How many thousands of people work here?
Thousands and thousands of people they used to work here. Look.
But there's a different material.
Granite. This is not sand, this is sandstone, but this is granite from Aswan. And I would like to show you Hatshepsut like a man with the horse beard. Look, all the pictures in the left-hand side, you see from the middle to the top, that is Hatshepsut with the double crown with the false spear. In front of whom? Who is in the right-hand side? Amun-Ra, you know what, the two blues, because she claimed that she was the daughter of Amun-Ra. How many cartouches she got? Two cartouches. This is the birth name, you see the goose Amun-Ra, and the coronation name in the top. She was the only queen, she got two cartouches. The coronation, you see the honeybee in the top?
Oh, yeah.
Underneath the honeybee, okay? But I was expecting to ask me, Mohammed, in this obelisk, we have two colors.
Two colors?
Two colors. You know, the bottom is pink granite.
Huh.
But look in the top, it's a little bit yellow.
That is sand?
No. You know her stepson? You remember I told you she cheated her stepson?
Yes.
And she took the throne from him, Thutmose III, and she sent him to jail when he was 9, and when he was 11, and she announced herself as the king of Abar and Lord Eve. And who fabricated the story for her of the divine birth? The priest of Amun-Ra. And her stepson, when he grown up, he succeeded to get out of his jail and came back, and he wanted to get revenge from her in those two obelisks. It was so easy for him to damage them in 5 minutes. But he couldn't do that. Why? Because those obelisks for Amun-Ra. And look, Amun-Ra here. And he still follows the same religion. But he still wanted to get revenge or revenge from her. What did he do? He wanted to make her oblivious. You know oblivious?
Erased her.
Forgetting. Forgetting.
Yes.
Forgetting. What did he do? He covered up that obelisk with a sandstone wall. All around.
Oh, okay.
So when Mohammed and his group comes, he couldn't read her name. He couldn't see her picture. And if you cover the bottom, you can see the top. So the top was uncovered for 3,500 years.
That's why the color
it changed its color from pink to yellow. And this is the reason why you don't have two colors. Okay?
Oh, yes.
This is the reason why you have two colors. Those are the offering rooms. You remember we said? Open courtyard, hypostyle halls, and offering rooms. And we are going to see how many sanctuaries here.
One.
But in Luxor?
Three.
Excellent.
Three for the guys.
Thank you.